I'm a little late. Then again, I'm a little early. What does that mean? Well, I normally come on about 7 Central and 8 Eastern. And I went on a while ago to tell you I'd be on at 6:30 Central and 7:30 Eastern. And I'm late for that, but I'm early for those who expect it at 7 Central and 8 Eastern. Now you get it? I'm late and I'm early. All at the same time. But that's okay. I'm going on early because I'm wore out. And I promised everybody I'd go on tonight, so I'm on. But this will probably be a little quicker than normal. But it's going to be a good one. It really is. It's going to be a good one. So everybody just kind of hang loose. Let me see here. I got to try to find something here. We're going to have, we're going to play some hymns tonight. And some little different versions of some of these hymns. And this was all prompted from an email I got Saturday night from Don Reed, my friend, the lead singer of the Statler Brothers. And I'm going to read what he sent to me, and you'll get it all pieced together. But these hymns are going to be great. You're going to love them. Let's see. Want to remind you that don't forget, if you haven't watched the video to I Like Southern Gospel Style the Best, go stay on my Facebook page here. Scroll down, and you will see that. And then tonight, I think, yeah, tonight at 8:30 Central Time, there's going to be another little video clip of me talking about who wrote the song and why I recorded it and how he came about writing it for me. So all of that, that'll be at 8:30 tonight on my Facebook page. So we will be done way before then, because I'm not going to be able to stand being up till then. So go back at 8:30 and watch that little video clip that we did. And then next week and the following for the next 10 weeks, one night a week, I'm going to post a new video, a different video of me talking about why I chose the songs on this album right here. Let me just get it here for you. If I hope I don't knock things over, because there's a good possibility of that. Nope, I did it with one hand. That album right there, I talk about. So next week I'll be talking about That's My Preacher and how that came to be in all of the songs. So there you go. Check that out. Now, it's not official, but for all of you that, you know, kind of watch the Facebook Live, and I have hundreds, so typically into the thousands, thank the Lord, that end up watching them each over like a week or so takes to get up into the hundreds and sometimes thousands, sometimes up to the multiple thousands. I think I've got 15,000 plus on several videos. But for those of you that are here all the time, you can go to YouTube. I am building a YouTube channel. It'll say Live with Les Butler. And so go join that YouTube channel. And it's going to have all of these shows and plus a whole bunch of other things that if you like what I'm doing on Facebook Live with Les, you're going to like all the stuff that I'm building on this channel. So go ahead and subscribe to the channel. And if you would, send it out to your friends and have them subscribe to the channel. Now, it's not near 100% built yet, but there's a bunch of stuff there. Let's just say you could spend many, many hours, even right now, without it even being done. And I think you would enjoy a bunch of that stuff. Okay, don't forget to go check out oldtimepreacherskwartet.com. I'm a member of that quartet, founding member, myself and Mike Holcomb. We own the Old Time Preachers Quartet. And even though I'm not traveling with them right now, because you know why, all the COVID and hospital and all the stuff, and I'm still dealing with it, they're back up on the road doing some things. And they sang last week for the first time since October. But they have several dates coming up. And it looks like I'm going to be with them on some, not many, but some, because I can't find somebody to pinch hit for me. So go check them out, oldtimepreacherskwartet.com. And of course, always go to the store. We've got this new CD, and we've got the Old Time Preachers Quartet CDs on there. And if you haven't done it already, here you go. We got to do this. Go buy a mug, Facebook Live with Les, right there. It says it right there. Whoop, whoop, whoop. And there I was, 46 pounds heavier then. You spend a few weeks in the hospital, you lose some weight. I'll figure that out. So go check all of that out at the store there. You can go to butlermusicgroup.com or oldtimepreacherquartet.com, and all of that will be there. Okay, let's see who's with us here real quick. Then we're going to get into the program today. We got Loretta. Good to see you, Loretta. Regina Leaf. Hello, my friend. Hello, my friend. Right back at you. Kevin Roberts. Hello, Les. Jeremiah Hart. Hey, Brother Les. Hey, Brother Jeremiah. You're going to like these hymns tonight, Jeremiah. Stay on. Then we got Daryl. Oh, you saw Don Reed, and there's Daryl. Daryl is my other brother from Statler Brother fan. Other brother for the Statler Brothers. I'm wore out too. Yeah, Brother Daryl, I'm tired, man. On top of, you know, I'm at 50% best case with this COVID stuff. The great news is for 8 days and nights now, I've been off of oxygen. Praise the Lord. But I have my lung stamina is still not anywhere close to being right. And my overall stamina is far from right. And as we speak, this is hour number 12 that I've worked today. I shouldn't be doing that. And I'm not doing that every day, but I had to today. And tomorrow I've got a big tracking day in Nashville. Riley's going to, I've been talking about Riley, what a great singer. I'm going to cut his tracks tomorrow, and I can't wait. It's going to be good. But anyway, so we're in the studio in Nashville all day tomorrow. And plus, on top of everything else, I'm trying to get a CPAP. I've got the CPAP, but I'm trying to get it to where I can sleep with this thing. And I'm into week three plus of that, and I've got to tell them within 4 weeks, so this week, Thursday to be exact, I got to tell them whether I'm keeping this CPAP or not. And I've gone through three different kinds of CPAPs over the last 3 weeks, and I'm not sleeping. So on top of everything, all of the other stuff, you sound like, Brother Les, you're just a whining complaint. No, I'm just telling you the facts the way it is. I'm wore out, so this is not going to be long tonight. Okay, hello, Deborah. Looking great. Well, thank you, Miss Debbie Lawrence. I appreciate that. I don't know how great I look, but I'll take that. And let me see here. I don't know what I've done there. Okay, here, let me see. We've got, hey, Isaac. Isaac is going to go to Jacksonville, Florida with me here in a couple weeks. He's going to be my toter. He's going to tote stuff because I can't tote yet. And Isaac, you'll be glad to know that Bev got a wheelchair for me for the airports, so you won't have to tote me. That's a good thing, Isaac, because if you had to tote me, God bless you. Kevin, you do a good job singing. Well, Kevin Roberts, you're being way too kind to me, but thank you for saying that. And see what else Kevin says. Thank you for sending the Family Music Group singles to radio. Oh, yeah, Kevin. Yes, sir, our privilege and honor. Gloria Miller Green, good evening, Brother Les. Hello. There's Scottina, Scott Edwards. Voice of Truth Quartet, practicing tonight. Come on, bring it, boys. Bring the heat. Let me tell you about the Voice of Truth Quartet. I've said it a few times over the past few weeks, but I previewed their album again. And by the way, Scott, I took it to the duplicator today, so they now have it. But I listened to it again top to bottom. I'm telling you, the Voice of Truth Quartet, this record is fantastic. And as excited as I am about it, and I am, I'm telling you, I can't wait to produce the next record. This was our first one together, and I figured some things out. And the next record, as great as this is, and it is great, the next record is going to be a record for the ages. I'm talking about it's going to get everybody's attention in Southern gospel music. They're going to say, oh, where did these boys come from? Voice of Truth Quartet, mark it down. Let's see, what else did he say here? We love you, brother. Yes, sir, Scott. We love you too, brother. Sure do. Great guys too. Oh, great guys. I can't say enough about the Boys of Truth Quartet. Hello, Mike. Hey, Liz Butler. Hey, Mike. Good to see you, sir. And who else we got here? Clayton Inman. Oh, no. No, that's Mike doing Clayton Inman. Scotty, Joy. Yeah. Look at there. He's putting all those names in. Right on, Mike. Do it, baby. Do it, big boy. Praise the Lord for wheelchairs, Isaac says. Yes. You're going to have to tote me. That wouldn't be good. Okay. So here we go. So here's the deal. So Don Reed, my friend, the lead singer of the Stapper Brothers, wrote me Saturday, and he sent a copy of this thing that he was doing for his Sunday school class. But before I read you the letter to the Sunday school class, or the Sunday school lesson, really, in essence, is what it is. I'm going to read the letter he sent to me. I told him after he sent the letter that I'm probably going to do a show on what he sent to me, and from the Sunday school class. So he said, if you do a show, you know I'll be watching. So and he always watches after the fact. He doesn't jump on live, but he watches all of them, man. It's great. I appreciate it, Don. I'll be watching anyway and still praying for you. Thank you, Don. Appreciate that. I sit many nights with my iPad and earphones and listen to your YouTube songs. Thank you. 99% are always Southern Gospel because that's where my heart is, was, and always will be. And I believe that, Don Reed. All my life, I have compared the talents of other fields, country, rock, folk, whatever, to Southern Gospel. What he's getting ready to say here, he is spot on. Hands down, there are more great singers and pianists in the gospel music field every time. Spot on. From a talent perspective, I don't care. Get any field of music, Southern Gospel wins. He continues, and you are a perfect example of it. Now, Don, thank you for that, but, well, just thank you for that. Your talents are only outshone by your heart. Again, thank you. I've never seen a man with more heart and more willing to show it than you. Again, thank you. God bless you, my friend. Continue on, Don. Okay, now, here you go. So here's what he sent to his Sunday school class. I'm going to read this. We're going to play four hymns tonight that he mentions in this note to his Sunday school class. It's called The Clock. A few years ago, Debbie, his wife, and I were shopping in Dayton, Virginia at the farmer's market. We were usually strolling through all the little stores and came through a gift shop with a wall full of beautiful and unusual clocks. One caught my fancy immediately, Don't think I ever have used that phrase before in my life. Sounds like something my grandmother might have said. Nonetheless, we know what you mean, Don. We understood. I understood it the first time I read it here. Every hour, the face of this clock would separate into a dozen pieces going every which way and then come back together into one piece. Now, how cool is that? All the time this was happening, instead of chiming, it would play an old hymn. How cool is that? I stood fascinated and asked the clerk to make it happen again. He did, over and over. I'd never seen anything like it, and I was completely charmed by it. Flash ahead to about 2 months later, and it's Christmas morning. I opened the package Debbie had given me this very clock because of the look on my face when I first saw and heard it. I was in love. The only question left was where to hang it. She took care of that also by placing it on the wall in our family den, right by the chair where I sat most of the time reading with my dog Lucy on my lap. Every day, every hour, I hear it on the hour playing a beautiful traditional hymn. About 30 seconds at noon of What a Friend We Have in Jesus. I'll keep reading in a moment, but since he's given us that song, I'm going to go ahead and play What a Friend We Have in Jesus, one of my all-time favorite hymns, in the top five of my all-time favorite hymns. And I've got a really unusual version of this hymn I'm going to play for you. It's from the Kingsmen, going back to the 60s. As I look at it here, early 70s, I see Johnny Parrick singing tenor. I see Eldridge. I think I see Hamill in there and Ray Dean. And it's got their live band. It's from an album called The Kingsmen Sing. I think this was a kind of a table product kind of deal. in kind of an obscure album and cut. So we're going to play this version of it. You know it. Sing along with the Kingsmen. What a friend we have in Jesus. And by the way, amen to that.
What a friend we have in Jesus.
Listen to Hamill.
All our sins and griefs to bear.
By the Kingsmen. What a friend we have in Jesus. Isn't that good? Boy, isn't that the truth? Oh my. What a friend. Like the one part of the song says, sometimes your friends will forsake you, not the Lord. Stick closer to you than a brother, and he'll be there to the end. What a friend we have in Jesus. Amen to that. And so this clock that Don Reed has at noon plays about 30 seconds of What a Friend We Have in Jesus. And he continues to say, it gives such a peace to me and to the house that I vowed to myself, I love this right here, to stop whatever I might be doing and listen to it every time it played. I'm still true to that self-promise that it's been a blessing that I look forward to even after all these years. So every hour, this clock plays a little bit of a different hymn every hour, and Don stops what he's doing and listens And I wouldn't be surprised if maybe he doesn't sing along sometime. Just my guess. Well, all right. Speaking of Don and the Statler Brothers, what say we let them do one? And boy, old Ray Dean sang some bass there a while ago. Let me tell you, Don's brother Harold gets it done on this song right here. And you know what? It's page 57 in the Redback. So won't you sing along with the Statler Brothers? Amazing Grace.
Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost.
Oh, here's the good news.
But now I'm found.
Oh, but now I'm found.
Was blind, but now I see. Was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved.
Unmerited favor of the Lord Jesus Christ. Sing along. Section, by the way, the producer in me is doing this right here. Wow. Nashville String Machine. No wonder it sounds so good. Amazing Grace. Grace, unmerited favor of the Lord Jesus. Not getting what we should get. grace. Hallelujah. Statler Brothers. Been reading a Sunday school note from Don Reed of the Statler Brothers that he sent to me about a clock his wife got for him. And it plays hymns every hour. And that's one of the hymns. As a matter of fact, that is the 1 o'clock hymn to be exact. Amazing Grace. And then at 2 o'clock, it plays another great old hymn, How Great Thou Art. And so I'm going to play a bit of an unusual version for you of this great song. But boy, it sounds good. And for you bluegrassers, you're going to love this. It's Doyle Austin and Quicksilver, their version of How Great Thou Art. With a piano, yes, from the bluegrass group Doyle Austin and Quicksilver. What about that? My mother sang this on her deathbed as she was getting ready to see that which whom she was speaking to and singing about.
When I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made.
What a great line. Read Genesis chapter 1. You'll know what he's talking about.
The stars. I hear the rolling thunder. Thy power throughout the universe displayed.
Yes.
Then sings my song, my Savior God to thee.
I'd sing it, Doyle Austin and Quicksilver. Listen now, he's coming any day.
With shout of acclamation to take me home.
I'm gonna be gone.
What joy shall fill my heart?
Joy, we're leaving heartaches, troubles, and trials behind.
Then I shall bow.
Yes, we will.
With humble adoration.
Oh, yes.
And there proclaim, my God, how great thou art.
Hallelujah.
Then
sings
my soul. My soul, my Savior.
nothing or no one any greater. Oh, Lord, how great thou art. Boy, amen. Doyle Lawson and Quicksilver with a piano and strings and all kinds of stuff. Very unlike Doyle Lawson and Quicksilver, our bluegrass friends. But I'm playing some kind of unusual versions of these great hymns, just to make it a little bit different. Let me find this final hymn here that I want to do, and we will play that here in just a moment. I'm going to read some of the comments that you're leaving on the show as well. But let me try to find this song first. Are you enjoying these great old hymns of the church? You simply cannot beat these great old hymns of the church is what I'm trying to communicate to you. They are the best. There's great songs being written today and being produced and recorded and being sent out today. Lord willing, tomorrow I'm going to be in a tracking session in Nashville where we are creating new music that's going to be great. You're not going to get any better than Amazing Grace and How Great Thou Art. We're just trying to get as close to that kind of greatness as we can. But boy, how great thou art. Again, one of three songs that my mother sang on her deathbed as she was getting ready to go visit, not visit, but live and stay with the one in whom that song was talking about. Oh Lord, her Savior, the Lord's Savior, Jesus Christ. She was getting ready to leave here. And with pulmonary fibrosis, with hardly any oxygen enough to do anything, she whispered it. Oh Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder, oh my word, all I know is you should have been in that hospital bed with two preachers and a deacon. We had full-on church, which by the way, did you know you can have full-on church even at the deathbed of a loved one? Oh yeah. Because you see, they're getting ready to go to that reward that we as a child of God, we get, not that we deserve it, not that we did anything for it, other than accept the free gift that the Lord Jesus Christ gave to us through his shed blood on Calvary's hill. That's why we get to go. That's why she got to go. But for the child of God, it's not sad. Sure, for those of us left behind, are there sad moments and days? Oh, yes. We miss them here. But do you realize that any day, we're going to go be with those loved ones who have gone on before in Christ? And by the way, get a hold of this. We're going to be with them much longer than we are without them. It's been 9 years. My mother died in 2012. This is 2021, 9 years. That's a long time, and I've missed her greatly for those 9 years. But any moment now, we're going to start eternity together, which is 9 years times 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 9 years into infinity. There's no stopping. There's no end. Hallelujah. And all that because how great, Lord, thou art. Well, glory. I said I was wore out. I wasn't going to stay on here very long, but I done got stirred up. Let's see who's on here with us before we play this last hymn. Let's see here. Brother Mike's still inviting people. Thank you, Mike, for doing that. I appreciate that. Patty Graham, there's no night in heaven. So we all arrive on the same day. That's right. John Hamlin, you're running well. Thank you, Brother John. Hallelujah. Loretta says she loves those old hymns. There's my Aunt Sue. She's joining in here. Kevin Garrett says, I miss hearing your mom sing. Kevin, I miss hearing her sing as well. But you know what? I'm going to sing with her a long time on a day that's coming up. Hallelujah. You can come on over and join us if you want, Kevin. It'd be all right with me. Yes, love that great old hymn of the church, my Aunt Sue says. Yes, yes, yes. John, love the hymns because they're all about him. That's right, Brother John. Yes, yes. Who else we got here? Well, I tell you what, I'm just going to keep going. We're going to play this last hymn because I am tired. We got to want to call it a night. Okay, so How Great Thou Art on Don Reed's clock plays at 2 o'clock. And then at 3 o'clock, this hymn plays. And then he says, those three hymns repeat at 4, 5, and 6. Amazing Grace, How Great Thou Art, In the Garden Then. And then 7, 8, 9, they repeat again. 10, 11, 12, they repeat again. But at 12, it also adds another hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus, which we already played. But at 3 o'clock, this is the hymn that is played. And I've got a version here by Master's Voice, fine quartet. Great version to this great old song, In the Garden. If you know it, sing along with them.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on
piece that Don Reed of the Statler sent to me about the clock that his wife bought for him that is on the wall over by the chair where he sits every day and every night. And every hour it plays Amazing Grace or How Great Thou Art or In the Garden. And at noon and at midnight, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. And he says whatever he's doing when he's there, and that plays, he stops what he's doing, and he pays attention to those old great hymns. And might I say, it'd be a good thing for us to do. When you hear one of those old great hymns, maybe somebody's singing it that you're around, or it'd be good for you just to, whatever you're doing every once in a while, to sing or hum along on an old great hymn of the church. It'll bless you. It sure will. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this little Facebook Live with Les, Southern Gospel Music, Memorabilia, Memories, Ministry. And we've tried to give you a little bit of all of the above there tonight, kind of an abbreviated program. Your old buddy Les is wore out. And so I'm going to bail and go rest for a little while. I got a big day in Nashville tomorrow, tracking day all day in the studio. And we'll be back, Lord willing, if he doesn't come to get us. Maybe Thursday or Friday night. So be watching for that. Now, don't forget, at 8:30 Central tonight or 9:30 Eastern, if you go to my, stay right here on this page where you are right now watching this program, Facebook, my Facebook page. And we're going to post another video of me talking about how I came to get the song I Like Southern Gospel Style the Best. Kind of a unique, kind of a novelty song that I recorded and just sent to radio, and it seems to be doing very, very well. I'm thankful for that. But there's a story behind that song and all the songs from my new album. And every week you'll be seeing a video of me talking about all of those songs and how they came to be and how I got them. And some very interesting stories, I believe. And so tonight at 8:30, there'll be a video with me talking about the song I Like Southern Gospel Style the Best. So check it out right here on my Facebook page, okay? Go to our store. That'd be wonderful if you do that. Get yourself a Facebook Live with Les mug or one of the CDs or anything else that we have there. My hymn, speaking of hymns, let me see if I've got one of those books handy right here. I've got a few of these left. Honestly, not very many, but hymns suit me fine. And there's stories in here from a bunch of your favorite singers and some of my preacher friends and even some fans who just sent in the stories about their hymns and why they were their favorite hymns, and some incredible stories in this book. I'm telling you, it's a great weekend's worth of reading. So Hymns Suit Me Fine, that book's in the store there, so go check that out if you'd like. And check out the Old Time Preachers Quartet schedule. That'll be there as well. And God bless you all. Would you all please hit the share button? I would appreciate it very much if you would do that. And Lord willing, we'll see you later this week. God bless you.